extended warm welcome to you on flight 883, Boeing 737 jet service, destined to Georgetown, Grand Cayman.
What's up? We back at it again. God has blessed me and my family and our ministry to be out here at the Grand Cayman Island, beautiful people. We serve a beautiful God, and we having a good time so far. One of the highlights since I've been here for the past few days is all the different primary schools and high schools I've been able to go to. I've been in about 11 different schools speaking in 2 days and two radio station interviews, and so that's 13 engagements in 2 days, and we've had a pretty impactful and busy schedule, but I wouldn't have it no other way. It's a lot of work to be done, a lot of motivation, a lot of inspiration that people need to receive, and I've been having a chance to go out here and touch these people and introduce them, and for some, reintroduce them to the power of God, and so it's been awesome, and we're looking forward to seeing what God has in store next.
Today, it was awesome. You know, being a young adult, going out into the street to witness to old, young, sick people today. Like Jeremy Anderson told us today, that we're not supposed to be of self, but be what the Lord wants us to be.
I'm telling you, the young people are on fire over here for Jesus. We are so delighted that Jeremy Anderson is over here. Man, he has been such a blessing to the 10 schools that he has touched. I have been personally blessed, and we are so grateful for his entire ministry and his entire team so that they could bring their blessings over here to the young people of the Cayman Islands.
Today was strong. It was hot, but it was strong. Out here in the Grand Cayman Islands, in a part of the island called West Bay. And everybody pretty much knows here on the island, West Bay is, they struggling. It's a lot of people hurting, a lot of people that's dealing with poverty out there in the West Bay. And so I was blessed to be with an organization called the Radical Youth for Christ. And we out here, man, just touching the people. Praise God. Can y'all see me okay? Is that better? Yeah, but it's hot, so I'm still right here. I found myself so consumed and so possessed that I didn't even know how to get out of the trap. I would leave my house at nights, and I would put a pistol in the back of my pants, and I would just say, Lord, whatever happens, save my soul. And so my father, that same man that had that type of faith in God, that said, I ain't gonna play God, saw me out there in the world and said, you know what, my son is being real successful. And what he did, he got aggressive with his prayer life, and that saved me. The power of intercessory prayer. If my father would have looked at my condition and thought that would have been my conclusion, I'd be gone right now. God put a comma there. Where you at right now, trust me. That's just temporary. I said it before, and I'm going to say it again. This is not your conclusion. This condition you're in right now, there is more to come. You should be asking God the same thing. What's that next level? Next level living is all about trying to find the next level for God. I want Jeremy to understand something, that God is using his ministry Next Level Living in a powerful way, man. I'm telling you, I'm like yesterday, I was not expecting people to like surrender. All I can say is that God truly showed up and he showed out.
This is what life is about. This is how the church is most effective, when you take the gospel and you bring it to people in the community. We can invite them to church all day long, but they may not show up. But what we gotta do is we gotta bring the church to them. We are the church, and that's exactly what we did. And the community came out, and we worshiped, and we praised God together. And then I gave a word. The Holy Spirit had me share my story. I gave a word, and then we gave the appeal. And you know what happened? The Holy Ghost did what he did best. He moved upon the hearts of people, and so many people gave their life to God, and some rededicated their life to God. Some even said, I want to get baptized, and we took them right to the East Bay and baptized them right there, and it was amazing.